Greetings to ArtBeats with Studio T. I'm your host Gailani, bringing you everything about the art world here in Oman. This series is sponsored by PK Exchange and Oman Avenues Mall. When we told you we'll bring you something interesting, today we are doing just that. We are at Matti Sirvio's Art Gallery and we're here for a special show called I See Music. Because we're going to be meeting a few of these artists, understanding what is it all about and what is that creativity. So let's go meet these artists. Let's meet our first artist, Aisha Al Bakry. Hi Aisha. It is so great to see you here with your art. So digital art has given you a perspective on what your art is. Oh, that's wonderful. So what is this piece about?
Okay, so this piece is actually called Music Sounds Better With You.
Music Sounds Better With You, like the song.
Exactly.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so I was inspired to do this piece after I caught my stepmom trying to throw out 300 of my dad's old records. And I was kind of shocked, and I decided that I would relieve her and take back my inheritance. And actually, I come from a very musical family. Not that we play any musical instruments, but we're just all really
obsessed. Your dad was a musician, right?
He wasn't, but he's always been into music.
Okay.
My sister happens to be a DJ. My brother was also a DJ at some point. Literally every single one of us loves all different kinds of, you know, music genres.
So the show I See Music really struck a chord with you, didn't it? And so it's you holding on to a family heritage. That story seems very personal, but aesthetically presented so vibrantly. How has this artistic journey to exhibit in this show been for you?
Honestly, I mean, when I started thinking about this piece, I knew that I wanted to depict something to do with a record, but I actually didn't draw it on a portrait scale. I designed it as a landscape. So if you look at it to the side, if you tilt your head, you'll realize that it actually looks like a portal. And the reason for that is whenever I think about music, 9 times out of 10, I'm definitely dancing, but I also feel like I'm transported into a space where I feel more like I'm connected with myself.
And I totally understand that. And it does, now that you say it, it does look like a portal. It does look like we're escaping somewhere. And that is such a fascinating story. And it's these stories that make art so interesting. It's these stories that these artists bring to us that makes coming to these shows so wonderful. Let's meet our next artist, Alma. Alma, welcome to the show. So they say abstract art is all about what the artist has inside his mind and his perspective, and then to the viewer, it's different to each viewer. So what does your art piece really mean, or does it say?
I'm very interested in science, and I have this personal theory that abstract art doesn't exist. With advance of technology, with microscopes and telescopes, we can see amazing colors and forms and combinations, constructs. And I don't think the human mind is able to imagine anything beyond what already exists. So when we say something is abstract, it's probably something we haven't seen yet. None of us has seen yet. But it carries the feeling of us humans collectively. So I use word abstract, but I also submit that I just had a little snippet of something that no one else has seen yet.
So it's something that is concealed to everybody, but something that you've thought of?
No, I don't think about it, but I submit to that truth, that realization. I'm not a creator. I'm just a channel through which the energy of the universe uses me to express something. And you will see an abstract painting, and 2 years later, there will be in a scientific magazine a photograph of something, literally photographed, and you'll think, that looks just like the
I totally get that. And I think that's what I think One of the best ways to explain artists is we are channels for creativity of the universe, and it just comes out through artists. Let's meet our next artist, Ms. Ghazaleh. Ms. Ghazaleh, welcome to the show, and it's great to be standing next to your art piece. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hello, thank you. My name is Ghazaleh Beirami. I am a lecturer at Art University and researcher and also visual artist.
So what do you think is the role of art in intercultural dialogue?
In my opinion, the role of art in intercultural discourse is very valuable in contemporary life. We need more dialogue, we need more understanding about each other, and to have understanding and respect each other.
So. Yes, and I think that's a key part that you've said is understanding and respecting each other, cultural dialogue. That's really what art does and brings all of these people together. Thank you for being on the show. Let's go talk to our next artist. So let's meet our next artist, Majid al Amri. Majid, so lovely to see you. So tell our viewers, how did you feel when you were painting this painting?
عندما رسمت اللوحة رسمتها بحيث أنه كيف ماجد يشعر عندما يسمع الموسيقى الحزينة فعبرت عن الحزن أو عن ماجد الحزين بهذه اللوحة من خلال ما يشعر به تجاه هذه أو الموسيقى الحزينة.
Okay, so what is your message for new artists?
Yeah, my message trust yourself and don't give up.
Trust yourself, don't give up. So that's a great message. Trust yourself and don't give up. Everybody should hear that, and we need to hear that a lot more often. Let's meet our next artist and what she has in store for all of us. Hi, Julia. Welcome to the show. Why don't you tell our viewers something about yourself and then something about this art piece?
Okay. So my name is Julia Davies. I'm from the UK, but I've been living overseas now for 27 years, in Oman for 6 years. I recently discovered that I'm a collage artist. It was a very recent discovery. And so this is a piece that I've made specifically for Matti's themed exhibition, the IC Music. And it's a collage, meaning I take pieces of imagery, found objects,
so,
and I compile
them. So this is all collage work?
It's all collage work, but if you're looking closely, you'll see I've also painted into it afterwards.
Yes, yeah, so it's collage with paint, and I see butterflies, I see elements, I see dance, I see life, I see musicals, I see Broadway, I see a lot here, and it's everything that I'm really fascinated about. How did this come about, and what is this? Is this a whole, this wheel is some...
After I finished, I realized it looks very much like the iris of an eye. Because this is an IC music theme, we have to visualize the music somewhere.
So, this is actually an eye.
It is an eye. It's called Symphony of the Eye.
And you know, what I was thinking is, the more I stand further from it and look at it, not only does it look like an eye, it also looks like a record.
Like a disc as well, a turning disc.
And there's a ballerina right there in the middle.
She's a synchronized swimmer.
Oh,
she is responding to music, but if you imagine her, she'll be under the water, she's submerged. So she's expressing that music without the sound.
Wow.
And so that's why she's in the depths of the eye. I wanted you to feel that she's submerged there and just take a breath around her, because she's doing that whilst holding her breath.
Oh, that's
and
fascinating.
All of the sound is her environment.
Because synchronized swimmers can't really hear the music.
They can't, no, and nor can they breathe. But yet they express music so beautifully and so, like a ballerina, like a dancer.
Oh, that's absolutely amazing. What is your advice to aspiring artists?
To enjoy yourself. To truly enjoy yourself. If you pressure yourself around your creativity, you instantly block it. Creativity for me is it's a joy, and it's something to do with well-being. And don't think of creativity as a product or something that you have to produce. Creativity is a journey and a process, and you should enjoy every step of it. And in that way, it will come naturally, and that will manifest in the final product.
A great word of advice, enjoy the process and enjoy the creativity so that you don't block it. Let's meet our next artist, artist Shrikant. Shrikant, welcome to the show. What a lovely piece. Tell us a little bit about your painting.
See, when I got this subject, actually, I see painting, I see music, actually. So basically, I am very impressed with this instrument since my childhood.
Tabla.
Yeah, tabla. It's called tabla. So I am very impressed with this instrument actually since my childhood. Actually, so I wanted to play with something music elements actually, and then luckily I got this subject. So I thought, no, why not do something completely different actually, away from the normal canvas painting. So I use here canvas strips here. To show the sound vibrations actually, you know, when you actually play the tabla instrument, you get the vibrations.
And these are the strings that hold the tabla drum, almost sort of distorted in your painting. It's an incredible interpretation of it creatively. So I'm also fascinated by the tabla, so I was very drawn to your painting. And you're right, all of this shows music visually. I think it's a great representation. What was your, how long did it take you to make this?
It takes me actually almost 20 days to do this painting.
A full month.
Yeah,
almost full
month actually.
Yeah. Wow. What is your message to other artists?
My message is like, you know, live life. And then enjoy your life each and every second actually, because life is so beautiful. And then if you enjoy with the music,
So live life and listen to music, and in this case,
see music.
Of the show I See Music. So Matti, what would you like our viewers to know about this show?
Well, this is actually our Autumn Salon, and this is Autumn Salon 2021. So for every salon, spring, autumn salon, we have a title. And the title for this show has been I See Music. Not just I hear music, but I see music. And I personally think that music and visual arts, they go so well together. I think most of the people agree with me. And why do they go so well together? Because they both kind of are a platform or an instrument for certain kind of values. I think softer values, I think they both can very well represent so-called softer values, which I think such as beauty, which is a very important value in the society, but it's a softer value. It cannot be priced, it cannot be calculated. It is something spiritual maybe, something sacred, such as emotions, love, hope, faith, forgiveness, those kind of things. I think art and music both inspire us in that. And this piece especially is, I love it because it's called I Can Only Imagine, and it's done by Rebecca, who is a Colombian artist based here in Muscat. And it's actually a song, and it's a song about heaven. And the idea is that I can only imagine what it is like.
I'm really intrigued by these pieces. I know the artist isn't here, so let us hear from you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for coming for a visit. Wonderful to have you. Yeah, these three pieces are done by a young American artist. His name is Alex Marquith. He's actually at an art residence in Finland at the moment. But he came here just for this show with his wife, and it was a great pleasure to have them. Because he represents a very typical, not typical, that's not a good word, but very interesting art from America today. And it's actually based on abstract expressionism, but it's kind of the contemporary version of it, including some graffiti and stuff like that. So he's been based in New York for several years. So you can taste that.
So that's a wrap of this episode. From Marty and all the other artists of this beautiful show, IC Music, we're signing off. Say bye, guys. Bye.